Welcome to SHOT TV's coverage of the Can-Am Women's Classic live from Portage la Prairie, Manitoba. I'm Jessica Cable, your host for tonight's event, which is part of the World Curling Tour and is proudly sponsored by Can-Am Inns. Maureen Bonner and Mike Beauregard will be with us throughout tonight's broadcast, and we will also be on Facebook and Twitter giving you highlights throughout tonight's game. Just search for SHOT TV Winnipeg. Let's head over to Maureen and Mike right now to see what we can expect from tonight's matchup.
Maureen, this is the inaugural Can-Am Inns Women's Classic, but really it's a continuation of the old Liquor and Lotteries Classic at Fort Rouge, which went on for about 10 years, and much like that event, pretty deep field here.
Yes, it is. We've got silver medalists from the Olympics, gold medalists from the Olympics. We've got 17 teams here that are on the top 50 in the World Curling Tour, so this is a deep field, and proud Manitoban. We've got 12 Manitoba teams here, so it's a very deep field.
Eight teams make the playoffs, six are already in, two more will qualify later tonight. This particular draw is an elimination draw. The winning teams move on, the losers are out. And our featured match pits a U.S. team up against a Korean team.
Yes, this will be interesting. We haven't seen a lot of these teams. They've come to Canada to curl, get experience here. They've been on the tour for a little bit the last couple months. A young U.S. team and a young Korean team that'll shoot the lights out, I'm sure.
It'll be Nina Roth up against Team Korea when we return. The opening draw is next. You're watching the Can-Am Inns Women's Classic live from Portage on SHOT TV.
Destination Centers, proud to support our community with 10 destination centers in Manitoba.
Hey, if you missed it in theaters, Shaw On Demand has you covered. Order Live, Die, Repeat, Edge of Tomorrow today.
They want to conquer the rest of the world. Unless you change the outcome.
We are not equipped for what's out there.
Times have we been here?
Hi, I'm Joel Poplosky. Ranger Insurance provides insurance coverage for Manitobans. We believe in building relationships and are proud supporters in the community. For more information, please visit rangerinsurance.ca.
Can-Am Inns Destination Center, Grand Forks. Over 200 family suites, kids theme, and standard rooms.
What's that?
Can-Am.
What's this?
Can-Am.
And Can-Am up there.
Can-Am.
Hi, my name's Tamika, and I host Switch on SHOT TV. Switch is a platform for community members to share different philosophies, cultures, and activities that happen in Winnipeg. And I think that's super cool.
Now I'm gonna plant the vegetables that I've started from seeds.
Switching up television.
I think it just means someone who loves the pop culture.
Run by volunteers.
Who I am online is who I am offline.
Community created on SHOT TV.
Hi, I'm Joel Poplosky.
Welcome back to the Portage Curling Club and the 2014 Can-Am Inns Women's Classic, just about ready to go. Our featured match pits a team from Korea, Oon Jung Kim, up against a team from the United States, Nina Roth, out of Wisconsin, now curling out of the U.S. Training Center in Blaine, Minnesota. This is a C event semifinal, meaning it's sudden death. The winning rink moves on to the C event finals this evening. The losing team is eliminated, and we've got three other matches going on simultaneously. Barb Spencer, a former three-time Manitoba champion, up against Allie Flaxie of Ontario. Val Sweeting is taking on Michelle Yagi of Switzerland, and another decorated Manitoba champion, Darcy Robertson, is curling Christy McDonald, formerly Christy Genyon, and we'll keep tabs on those games. And Maureen, in terms of our featured match, they've met already in this event.
Yes, they did. I talked to their coach, Patty Withrich, about that game, and it was a tight game until about the fourth end, and they just had a little blip and lost that game, but I think this will be a good rematch. They played really well this morning, according to Patty, their coach, the Korean team, so I think this will be a great game.
So Anina Roth's team beat Team Korea 6-3 in that match. Roth and her U.S. team have two victories and two losses in this event, and there you look at Nina's lineup. And really a collection of curlers from across the U.S. Nina's from Wisconsin originally, as I mentioned. And Team Korea has a record of 3 wins and 2 losses in this event. And they've been very busy on the World Curling Tour this season. They've already played 4 events, so this is their 5th of the young season. And they have a decent record, 14 wins and 10 losses over the course of these events.
They've played some really great teams along the way as well, and that will bode well for them leading into their national championship in the next, week. They're going to be going back to play in that national championship.
Just completing the warm-up here at the Portage Curling Club. Back-to-back events here in Portage. Of course, last week we had the Can-Add-Ins Men's Classic with Mike McEwen winning for the 3rd time in 4 years, and now a Women's Classic. And they're really excited about it here at Can-Add-Ins and here in Portage. And a good run, Maureen, for the lotteries event in Winnipeg, and it's a shame that an event has to leave Winnipeg, but it's found a good home here, I think.
Yes, it has, and kudos to Portage Curling Club for taking this on as well, and the ice makers here, Baron Ashen, and I think they had actually Mr. Uwasco come down and do a little tweaking of the ice, so this is a great event. It's great ice. We've got lots of great teams here. It's a nice place to hold it, especially at the Can-Add-Ins here.
I think Greg Uwasco would tell you he's too young to be called Mr., but... yes, he contributed to the ice last week, helping out Farrell Ashram, and he's back again this week. What do you make of some of the other matches on at 5 p.m. here, all elimination matches, as we've mentioned?
Well, yes, we've got some Manitoba matchups, maybe a preliminary view of the Scotties Tournament of Hearts coming up in January. But, yeah, I think there'll be some great games. Christy Genyon's, Christy McDonald now, is playing against,
Darcy Robertson.
Darcy Robertson, right. And Darcy has been on the circuit for quite a while, and that'll be a good matchup between those two teams.
8 teams will qualify for the playoffs tomorrow, and if you're thinking of coming down to the Portage Curling Club, we'll have the quarterfinals tomorrow morning, Monday morning at 10 a.m., the semifinals at 2, and then the final at 6 o'clock. And if you can't make it down, you can watch the championship final tomorrow night, 6 o'clock, right here on Shaw TV. 6 rinks are already in. Jennifer Jones, Jill Thurston, and Chantel Eberle of Regina, all undefeated with 3 wins, no losses. They qualified through the A event and qualifying through the B event. Team Japan, and they've had a good start to their young season. Michelle Eglot of Regina and Margarita Sigfridsson of Sweden, the silver medalist from the Olympics. So all 6 of those rinks already qualified for the championship round tomorrow.
Let's South Korean team is just finishing up their practice ice here, and they'll be drawing to the button to determine who will have hammer for this game.
Maureen has her stopwatch out as we take a look at Team Korea's skip, Eun Jung Kim.
Excellent draw. I think they have solidified the hammer for this start of this game. They didn't even have to measure it.
And so we're set for our C event semifinal elimination match. In the red, Team USA, Nina Roth. Against Eun Jung Kim of Korea. Eight end games on the World Curling Tour.
It'll be interesting to look at Nina Roth's record. She lost two qualifiers and ended up down in the C event now, so she's going to want to go out and win this one so she can get to the last qualifier of this event. She's come up against a couple of tough teams along the way, so Jill Thurston was one of them, and Sigurdsson was the other, so she's had some big games behind her.
And Maureen, by the time the playoffs roll around tomorrow, if she were to qualify through the C events, that's a lot of games in a short period of time. Advantage or disadvantage?
Well, some would say advantage, because you keep limber, you're aware of what the ice is doing. It depends on how much, you know, prep work you've done leading into the season, and obviously both of these teams have been curling quite a bit, so I think it would be an advantage. You keep sharp, you keep in the game, you're, you know, focused for three days straight, so I think it's an advantage.
Compared to those who have qualified through the A event, they had today off and will obviously have a short time on the ice here to practice, but not quite the same, I guess.
Right. A lot of these ladies, they work out throughout the year and are in very good shape, and that's what it takes to, you know, get to Monday qualifier when you do go through the C side of the draw. I think that, you know, this Korean team has done their bit working out over the whole year, and they've had a very heavy playing season so far, being in Canada for the last 5 weeks.
Well, if they came here to get some playing experience and get in some games, they're certainly doing that.
Well, they actually need to. I was talking to Patty Withrich, their coach, and they really don't have a lot of competition in South Korea other than the other reigning champion there. But there's one official curling club in South Korea. Outside of in Seoul, they have an arena that they transfer over into a curling format. But basically, MJ, the fifth alternate, her dad owns the only curling club. So they have privileged ice access that will help them. So they're just throwing up the... coming around here on an outturn, coming around the two guards in front of the house.
I'm amazed that rinks from some of these developing curling countries can actually come here and actually compete with teams who pretty much do this full time.
Well, you know, they really take the game on seriously, and they're very, very astute at the technical part of it. You know, teams like Japan and Korea, very, very solid on their deliveries and the technical delivery. It's just a matter of the strategy being a little bit a little weaker, and so they work on that, because let's face it, they don't curl a lot of teams throughout the year, so they come over to Canada and this is where they get that experience. This Korean team was just thrilled. They played in a event in Sweden and ended up taking Jennifer Jones down to Last Rock, and they also beat Rachel Holman there, so they were thrilled to play those big names and you know, be in the game with them.
Well, one of the qualifiers through the B event side, the team from Japan, they've already won twice on the World Curling Tour this season. The game is changing.
It sure is.
And for the better, we're in the opening end of our featured match. A C event semifinal between Team USA and Team Korea.
Fairly simple first end, hitting and rolling here behind the front guard.
This is USA second, Becca Hamilton.
We just tried to draw around that front guard. Get it nice and tightly tucked in behind there. South Korean skip will just ask her to throw easy weight at this and try and hit more early.
Here's Team Korea second, Song Young Kim. Thought through this shot thoroughly.
I think she just overthrew that a little bit. I think she was expecting it to be a little softer weight to come down there. So that'll give the opportunity for Team Roth to put another one in around that tight guard.
Into third stones now, here's Jamie Sinclair. The third for Team Roth. Deeper than what she had anticipated, Maureen?
Yeah, going behind into the forefoot allows Team South Korea to draw in there and take away the 2 points that are laying there right now. So she'll just try and draw around there. She went for the hit and roll and executed it very well.
And that was Kong A. Kim, the third for Team Korea.
So Nina Roth will just ask for her third. Jamie to remove this stone and hopefully just stick right there would be perfect. Thank you.
Team USA lying two. Last of the third stones now. Kong A-Kim. The third for Team Korea. They have the hammer here in the opening end of our featured match.
She was trying to get a hit and a roll into the center there, Mike, but it tracked on her. A little bit harder lead, I think, just left it run straight down there. Meanwhile, just do the same. I don't think she wants to roll anywhere near that 4-foot rock to create a basket for Team South Korea to get to. So she'll be happy to just sit and stick right there.
Winning team here moves on to the C event finals tonight with the hope of getting into the playoffs. $60,000 on the line this weekend here in Portage. First of skip stones. Nina Roth hits and sticks to lie two.
And Jung Kim will try and just hit and roll over to that one in the back 4 foot. He played pretty much all the stones on this right-hand side, so it'll be interesting to see how they mix it up on the next end. We know they can throw out turns.
A reminder, we're back on the air tonight at 8:30 with the C event finals. Here is Oon Jung Kim.
That's a great shot.
Just a bit of shot stone poking out.
Your last one was 10-1, so it's about the same weight.
And there is enough room between those two rocks for Nina Roth to come down and tap it out and roll away. She'll have to negotiate that back yellow one.
Can't see it much of it, Jamie. Yeah.
Well, Nina's taking a look at it and doesn't like the look from the hack. That's one thing, you know, you get in the hack and it looks a little different, so you need to get up out of the hack, go take a look at it and see it from that different angle. Looks easier at one end from the other.
And it looks a lot easier on television.
Yeah.
Last stone for Nina Roth here in the first end, facing one. Team Korea has the hammer. Can they hold the line? Oh, it gets by.
Wow, that was great sweeping from the front end of Team USA. They held that.
Well, you hate to put a huge bit of importance on a shot in the opening end, Maureen, but these are eight end games and you get behind by a couple early.
That's for sure, Mike. You want to make sure that you get used to the ice first couple ends and sometimes play it tight to the vest a little bit. Don't take too many chances. Get your confidence of the ice and your team comfortable. It's an interesting shot by Oon Jung Kim. I'm not sure if she's actually playing the hit or the draw. Most people would just draw to the 4 foot and take their point. It looks like she's chosen to draw.
last rock in the first event end of our featured game. Team Korea facing two U.S. counters. And she'll draw 4-1. So the U.S. forces Team Korea to take one in that opening end, and they lead 1-0 after one end of play. Earlier, our Jessica Cable spoke to the skip of Team USA.
I'm here with Nina Roth, one of the skips from one of the U.S. teams competing here in Portage la Prairie. This is your first time here in Manitoba competing in Portage la Prairie. How's it been going so far?
It's been going really well. My team's staying really positive, and we've been just improving game to game.
And you guys, actually, you played Team Korea. You beat them 6-3 in Saturday's draw. How do you guys do that again here tonight?
We're just going to keep to our game plan, play really simple, just do our best.
Awesome, perfect. Thank you so much. Best of luck tonight. And stay tuned. We have more from the Canadiens Women's Classic live in Portage la Prairie.
At Shaw TV, we are proud to bring you live events and we value your comments. Call the Shaw TV viewer response line now, 204-480-3500, or email us, shawtvwinnipeg@shaw.ca, and let us know how we're doing. Or find us on Facebook and Twitter at Shaw TV Winnipeg.
Welcome back to Portage and the Canadiens Women's Classic. Mike Beauregard, Maureen Bonner, and Jessica Cable. Pleased to be bringing you the inaugural Canadiens Women's Classic. And our featured game has Team Korea leading Team USA 1-0. Eun Jung Kim of Korea up against Nina Roth of the U.S., who has come to Portage and was hoping just quietly to put up a good record, and all of a sudden she finds herself on television.
Yes. Well, just to recap what's happened so far in this end, Team Korea put one in the house by Ian Button, and Tabitha Peterson from the U.S. team put a corner guard up, and now they're into the second Leeds Rock, just putting a guard up front to cover that Button shot rock.
This is a sudden death game. There are three other matches going on as we speak. Spencer against Flaxi, Sweeting against Yagi, and Robertson against McDonald. And we'll update those as we get scores. All three are scoreless so far in the opening end. Here's a look at Tabitha Peterson, the lead for Team USA.
And Tabitha is drawing around on the intern, that corner guard she put up with her first rock. Interesting that they are going to use their corner guards. That's always a bit of a dilemma with teams, not using the corner guards when they put them up. So she has definitely put that corner guard into play.
What would she be saying there, Maureen?
Well, I think she's asking her to throw just a down weight, come around that corner guard, take the rock in the back that Tabitha just put there from the U.S. team, and tap it out. And she's saying, if you hit the corner guard, that's okay, but get one or the other.
Your Korean's very good.
Yeah, been practicing. Lovely shot.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
can't see anything.
Hawkwind, it'll come
in. Or you just get the guard.
Becca Hamilton, the second from the U.S. team, is just conversing with her skip to find out what she wants to play. She can't see much from the hack, so I think this will just be a delicate weight shot that she tries to come around and just open it up or come to the back one and tap it back just a bit. I think there was a bit of confusion there from Becca Hamilton and Nina on what the call was. A little bit confusion on what they were playing there. So South Korea will just put a guard back on top and put the pressure back on Nina Roth. I think she can see more of it this time, so she'll definitely try that same shot again and try and tap it out.
Second stone for Team USA second, Becca Hamilton.
Even though she's not shot, but that's a good shot. She got the one off the button and rolled behind the corner guard. It'd be a little bit of a chaser for South Korea to go after that rock. Again, some discussion on what do we want to do here. Do we want to draw or do we need to go after that rock? And I think she's looking at the draw. The thinking here, Mike, is if they go for that back yellow one in the back 12 foot, they're going to be going from the outside in. And if they roll away, it gives Nina Roth, the U.S. team, the chance to go out of the guard and get a good rock in there.
Into third stones now, Kong A Kim. The third for Team Korea.
Not a bad shot. If Nina has to negotiate it a little bit, if she's gonna bump it back and not touch her own. She has options to go around the center guard, sit on that one at 9 o'clock, the rings.
Jamie Sinclair throws third rocks for Team USA.
Her bio says she is originally born in Alaska. It's well executed by Jamie.
But 지금 1점보다는 또 약하게 와도 된다.
I think South Korea will just ask to do the same shot, come down and tap it back.
Second stone from Kong Ai Kim.
She came down and tapped it, but Nina Roth, the U.S. team, is still shot rock. And so now she'll likely choose to split the rings so she can count two or be sitting two.
If you go under, as long, you have to be top eight, butter of the four.
If we go under, we got to play this way. But I like this too, back eight.
Well, you're behind T. T, you're better, right?
Like this?
When you cut the rings down, it's harder to get your two or lay two. Going around this way, you could possibly set up a double or a hit and roll onto your shot rock.
Last of the third stones. USA has the hammer, already lying one here.
Well, US lost an opportunity there to lay two. That rock over curling into the 12 foot. So now South Korea will just draw in and bite the four, try and bite the 4 foot. And it'll be forcing, looking like a force.
We're into skip stones in the second end. This is the first from Eun Jung Kim. Leading Team USA 1-0. An elimination game here at the Canadiens Women's Classic. Tight line.
Yeah, they're working this hard. They need to bite the forefoot. This opens the door for the U.S. team to draw in there and in turn. If they can bite the forefoot, they'll be lying two yellow rocks.
In one of the other elimination games going on, Darcy Robertson leads Christy McDonald 1-0 in the second end. No other scores to report.
Yeah, but around this
just
way?
Yet.
I mean, right, but then if we stick out at all, we're giving them a double opportunity. A little bit more, Jamie. Yep.
First stone for Nina Roth. What was that discussion about, Maureen?
I think they were just looking at taking a little more ice. She wants to make sure she gets around that tight 12-foot rock of South Korea's. I think it's bending a little bit more. I talked to some of the curlers before the game and say it does a lot of its movement at the bench, just outside the hog line. So you have to really anticipate that. And she wants to make sure that she gets to where she needs to and sits to, puts the pressure on South Korea.
Good job by the front end there on a track of ice they hadn't been down yet.
That was really nice weight by Nina Roth as well. So a bit of a dilemma here for South Korea. You know, they've got to make sure that they tap this one back. They won't eliminate both stones, yellow stones, but they can look at tapping that yellow stone on the 4 foot back. She's kind of looking at the angles here. I'm not sure what she sees, but. My Korean's not that good, I guess, Mike. She keeps looking at the angle on the two yellow ones. I'm not sure if she thinks she can angle it across for a big end here, but I don't know if that is possible. She is worrying too about hanging out and jamming her yellow rock onto the U.S. yellow rock onto her blue rock at the back of the house. So she's going to negotiate this with easy weight.
USA has the hammer here in the second. Here's the last stone for Eun Jung Kim. Tight line, gets through.
She avoided the jam. So it'll give the opportunity for the US team to draw for two. Away that intern draw that U.S. threw down there, so she'll have to take the outturn draw now. Let's see, South Korea just made that takeout. So she will elect to draw the outturn. This is new territory. She hasn't drawn on this side yet. And she just needs to bite the forefoot. Just. It sounds so easy, eh?
It's an extremely easy game from up here, Maureen. Last rock, second in. USA already lying one, has a chance for two. And this one won't get there. May have picked up something.
Well, we hadn't played a lot of outturns down that side of the ice, so it might have still been a little bit fresh. Maybe had to give it a little bit more weight down that side and new territory.
A missed opportunity for the U.S. They get just the one here in the second end, and we have a 1-1 tie heading for the third. Before this match, our Jessica Cable spoke to Team Korea skip Eun Jung Kim. Here's that interview.
I'm joined by Eun Jung Kim from Team Korea. You guys have been playing in Canada for 4 weeks now. What's it like to play here in Canada?
일단 훈련하러 왔는데 네, 캐나다에서 컬링이 되게 잘 하고 그렇기 때문에 배우기 위해서 캐나다에 오게.
Yeah, we for the training, because Canada has so many good teams. We want running the better skill and more experience.
Perfect. Well, best of luck tonight. We'll have more from the Canadiens Women's Classic live from Portage la Prairie.
You're looking live at action from the Canadiens Women's Classic. C Event Semifinals Elimination Games. Our featured match has a team from Korea skipped by Eun Jung Kim up against Team USA and Nina Roth from Blaine, Minnesota. 1-1 is our score. This is a rematch of a game earlier, actually, in this event, won by the USA 6-3. Three other elimination games going on. Darcy Robertson leads Christy McDonald 1-0. Michelle Yagi of Switzerland has a 1-0 lead on Val Sweeting, and no score between Allie Flaxie and Barb Spencer. A couple of former Manitoba provincial champions and Canadian junior champions out there, and Darcy Robertson and Barb Spencer, Maureen.
Yes, and mixed, Manitoba mixed champions as well. They played with their father and brother in a couple of mixed championships. So they've junior, women's, and mixed. In this game, the U.S. team has just put up the front guard and is just trying to eliminate, close off the forefoot for South Korea. Just about missed that.
Four?
So Team USA, Nina Roth will ask her to draw a corner freeze to the South Korean stone. It's just in front of the forefoot. This is a little cat and mouse here at this moment. They'll play to the forefoot and try and position their rocks to take control of the forefoot area. Team Roth is actually a junior champion as well, national champion from the States. She won the junior nationals in 2008, 2009, actually 2006, 2008, 2009, and has competed at the U.S. Women's National Championship, winning a national championship in 2010. So this U.S. team has a lot of experience, young as they are. Well curled.
USA with two wins and two losses in this event thus far. They beat Chelsea Carey in their opening match, and Chelsea unfortunately lost all three of her games and has been eliminated.
Yes, Chelsea had a tough go this weekend. We also had a couple other Manitoba teams that had a tough go. We had a local team, Dawn Moxham. And she competed in this as well from Portage. 50. Her husband is Dean Moxham. Played several years for, I want to say Scales, but it wasn't Scales. I just had a blank. But played several years curling in the men's championships.
8 teams make the playoffs. 6 are already in, including Jennifer Jones, who is off to a 3-0 start. Jill Thurston has also advanced with a perfect record. Chantel Eberle of Regina. And they are joined by a team from Japan. Michelle Englott of Regina and Margarita Sigfridsson of Sweden. 2 more will join them this evening, qualifying through the C event finals.
Looking at a couple options here. Either to tap that yellow one back and roll away to the side, 12-foot rock. I think they're discussing the merits of drawing around on the intern as well. She really wants them to freeze to that corner, freeze to that front rock of the 8-foot.
Last of the second stones, this is Song Young Kim of Team Korea in a 1-1 tie, curling the third here in a sudden death game at the Canadiens Women's Classic. We're back on the air at 8:30 with the C event finals.
That's a pretty good shot, Mike, Song Young Kim just put in there. Nina's asking for an outturn draw down to the one in the 4-foot. That's pretty much fully buried, so it's going to be tight to get around there, but this will be a weight shot. All weight and all up to the sweepers. Excellent shot. South Korea still lane one, but there's a lot of granite in front, and she's going to likely ask to clean that up.
맞는 것도 빠지는 거?
네.
이거 4번. 이렇게.
아니, 이거요.
She can look at hitting 같이. That front 12-foot rock onto the yellow one and have a catcher on the side for that back yellow one. So she's got options here if she does take that front one out. But I think at this point she's looking at trying to open it up a little bit. I think she's electing to throw the out turn and tap that back onto the yellow one. And hopefully her shooter will stick around onto the right side of the ice. Patty's done a lot of work with these ladies. She's worked on getting a true and crisp release out of them, because sometimes the foreign teams have a tendency to throw lazy handles and they lose their turn. So she's worked really hard with them to get a distinct turn on their rocks. That was really, really a nice rock that she just threw there.
Or just come in this way.
You don't mind?
Corner feet, 3-4.
Not having the hammer, Nina's going to want to look at getting another rock in the rings. She's got second and fourth stone in there right now, so she's going to want to come into the rings and possibly even get shot of this draw. Again, we're looking at this intern draw, which they haven't thrown a lot on this side of the ice.
Second stone from Team USA third, Jamie Sinclair. Team Korea has the hammer here in the third. An exchange of singles thus far in a 1-1 tie. Last of the third stones.
Great shot, Mike. They outturned takeout, just tapped it enough out and left them laying three South Korean stones.
If you're Team USA here, Maureen, are you concerned?
Yeah, she should be concerned. She only has two rocks left, and there's
Korea
three
stones. Korea has the hammer.
Yeah, and Korea has the hammer. There's options here. Mike, she can look at taking the outturn double. And her shooter may roll over to the catcher on the right-hand side on the 12-foot. Or look at just, it looks like she's going to play the hit,
likely
going for the double.
You guys like the double or like using it as backing and coming around again? The two first and second shot.
The danger here, Mike, is if she doesn't make the double, she's looking at having one rock left, and South Korea is going to be set up for a big count here. So this is a really critical shot here.
Skip stones, third in, Team USA, Nina Roth facing three. Needs to spill some blue stones. Gets one.
Okay. Minjung Kim can barely see all of this rock, just almost all. So she has to negotiate getting by the guard, and she gets a little wide, she might go back on that back one in the forefoot. So she's got to negotiate that front stone, get by that, and hit the yellow one out. She'd like to stay right there, and then that would force the U.S. to make a decision on drawing around or coming down to take the end, cut the end down.
And you were saying this Korean team is coached by a local.
Yes, coached by Patty Withrich. I think people out there will know Patty and her husband, Hans. Hans Withrich is well known across the world for making exceptional ice, and still does. Patty, of course, is a Canadian and Manitoba champion. I had the pleasure of curling with Patty years ago. Not too many years ago, but years ago. And she's taken on the last 18 months working with this Korean team.
When she was Patty Vandy.
Patty Vandy, Vander Kirkhoff.
First stone for Team Korea. In good shape here. They get the nose hit. It's all blue, line three.
That was well executed. Really good control of her tap back weight there. She didn't overthrow it. It ran nice on her. They just swept it a little bit down, and she's lane three.
I mean, it'll be close, but do you like that?
It's a big dilemma for Nina Roth. She has a couple of choices. She can raise the guard out front, back. Again, going on that in turn, they haven't played that in turn side very much, so the ice is going to be a little bit tougher out there, and they haven't seen the line. So this is going to be a real tough shot for the tap back. Or she could just straight draw and try and get a piece of the forefoot. The other option is to hit that outside blue one that has been replaced and try and roll in.
Then the backs are getting stiff.
Cuts her down.
Yeah, I mean,
cuts South Korea down a couple points if she moves to make that perfect.
Yeah. What do you think? I'm leaning towards the double, but then I'm rolling out. I'm rolling out, and they might be jamming on those. Okay, well, if we hit and roll, if you roll to right behind it, they don't have a run. Or it's roll to here, the run jams onto this back one, right? So that's pretty good. I really want to make this draw.
I think I heard Nina say that she really wanted to play the double. And her third, Jamie Sinclair, is looking at the hit and roll. This is the point where you go, I feel comfortable throwing this. I want to throw this as a skip. She's elected for the hit and roll.
Critical shot for Team USA, facing three here in the third. Last rock to come.
Just an excellent shot. That's the best she could have done there. A beautiful roll. Now that cuts the Korean shot down to possibly just going for two, unless they elect to play. They're pretty gutsy. They're looking at that front rock. Great shot. Look at that hit and roll, perfectly executed. Minjung Kim's looking at the straight back. Blue onto yellow, passed. Not hitting the back, 4 foot one, and possibly for three. She's not taking a lot. She's taking enough ice. I think she's just going to play easy weight at this. It's all about risk and reward at this point, Mike.
And this is a little more risky than just drawing for two?
Yes.
Last rock, third ends. Team Korea with a chance for multiple points here against the U.S. Oh, and they bump the U.S. stone in 4-1.
Risk and reward, as I said, you know, that was always a danger. And, you know, you'd look at the scoreboard and two isn't a bad score to take your two and run. That's what you play, you know, to get each end, to get your deuce. So that won't bode well for South Korea, and they'll be talking about that one over the break.
So in what looked like a one-sided end for Team Korea, ends up in a steal of one for Team USA. They lead 2-1 after three ends of play in our featured match. There are three other elimination games going on. And here is last rock, Val Sweeting. Second end, curling Michelle Yagi of Switzerland. Sweeting is facing a couple. Down one in the match. Bumps her own stone in to score one. How about that?
That's a great shot. That's the Val Sweeting we know, we've seen throughout the years, couple years. Great shot by Val.
1-1 is the score in that game. Curling in the third end. You're watching the Can-Am Inns Women's Classic live from Portage on Shaw TV. Back in a moment.
Destination Centers, proud to support our community with 10 destination centers in Manitoba.
Hey, if you missed it in theaters, Shaw On Demand has you covered. Order Live, Die, Repeat, Edge of Tomorrow today.
They want to conquer the rest of the world. Unless you change the outcome.
We are not equipped for what's out there.
How many times have we been here?
Hi, I'm Joel Poplosky. Ranger Insurance provides insurance coverage for Manitobans. We believe in building relationships and are proud supporters in the community. For more information, please visit rangerinsurance.ca.
Welcome back to the Can-Am Inns Women's Classic Sudden Death Game on the C event between Nina Roth of the U.S. and Team Korea. And it's the U.S. leading by a score of 2-1. Really, Maureen, a case of missed opportunity. The U.S. in the second end had a chance for a deuce. They come up with one. And in the last end, Team Korea could have had as many as perhaps three, and they give up a steal of one.
Yeah, they could have just gone for the simple two and look at the scoreboard and, you know, a two-point difference at this point, 3-1. So now they're on the offense trying to generate points in this next end. They've put up their corner guard, South Korean team, and they're playing down to the U.S. team's rock right now that has been put in the top 4 foot with a guard out front.
$60,000 up for grabs in the Can-Ad Inns Women's Classic. And did you play for this kind of money?
Yeah, along the way, we've played for quite a bit of money. It's a tough road, you know. A lot of these curlers out here have to negotiate work, time off. They have to negotiate family commitments. And some of them still have to negotiate school commitments as well. So it's becoming even more intense than when I was on the tour. So a lot of time spent. There'll be those that are here till Monday will get home and change of clothes, pack another bag, and head out for the next weekend.
Well, the Masters of Curling's coming up in Selkirk, so a number of these rinks will just stay put. This event has attracted some of the top money earners on the World Curling Tour. Jennifer Jones is here. Team Japan have already had some early season success.
Just for those people out there that follow the World Curling Tour or are not familiar with it, the money list is on the curling website, and Rachel Holman, Jennifer Jones, Agasawara from Japan are at the top three money winners right now. Any money that's won at this event will go on that list as well, and then it helps with their ranking as well, their point ranking. And like I said in the opener, we've got about 17 teams in this Bonsville that are in the top 50 getting at the World Curling Tour. So, you know, they're all looking for those elusive points. It helps them get invited to the major events, and also helps with getting them to options of different things within different countries, of course, but in Manitoba and provincials in our country, Manitoba has the option. You top point tour gets an automatic berth into the Scotties Tournament Heart. So Manitoba teams are looking for these points for sure at this Bonsville.
Jennifer Jones' team, they haven't played all that much so far this year, but they're second on the World Curling Tour money list. Won a huge event, actually the first Grand Slam event of the season, the Curler's Corner Autumn Gold Classic, beating Rachel Holman in the final. And they are 3-0 so far here in Portage and have qualified through the A event for tomorrow's playoffs. And that team from Japan that you were referring to, they've already won twice on the World Curling Tour this season.
Yes, it's almost like a job for some of these international teams that come across to play on our tour. They're here for a number of weeks, like the South Korean team. They get a lot of curling. They'll be going home in the next week to curl in their national final. And the European finals are around the same time as well. So they declare their national championship teams a lot earlier than our Canadian teams are crowned. So it gives them a lot of opportunity to prepare for the world championships.
USA leads Team Korea 2-1. We're in the fourth end. Winner advances. Loser is eliminated. And in our other elimination games, Darcy Robertson and Christy McDonald, a battle of two Manitoba rinks. They're tied at one. Val Sweeting and Michelle Yagi are tied at one as well. And it's Barb Spencer leading Ali Flaxi of Ontario 1-0. So no one is getting blown out today on the 5 o'clock draw.
You'll sometimes see that in the C event. Everybody wants to continue on. They'll play it a little tighter to the vest, won't take as many chances perhaps, and play the scoreboard a little closer too, so that they get to that qualifier. That's the goal on a Sunday evening. South Korea trying to generate some points in the house and set up some opportunities for themselves to generate those points that they missed last end. And the U.S. team just trying to double and just missed. Couple options here. She can hit and roll and lay two. I know she was looking at corner freezing to that top one, which would be another option as well. I like this option though, splitting the house, getting another blue one in there to roll to the other side. A little bit of discussion there, but I think she's decided to hit and roll to the side and lay two. Well, she got the yellow rock out, Mike, but I think it was a little harder than she anticipated. She threw it a little harder and it rolled too far, so she's left herself only line one, and the U.S. will soon be taking that off as we speak.
Here's Jamie Sinclair, the third for Team USA.
Here's a missed opportunity by Nina Roth's team. That was wide open. She must have got that going a little bit. So now that opens the door again for South Korea to put another rock in there and sit second shot. Sometimes you don't need to worry about that third stone just at this point in the end, but she's electing to go after it and lay three. You can see about three quarters of it. Nina has some options here. She can hit and roll behind the corner or hit and roll to the blue South Korean stone over to the left. If she does roll over to the South Korean rock, it might set up an opportunity to double later on in the end with her last stone.
Into skip stones now, and the fourth, USA with a 2-1 lead.
Oh, So hopefully South Korea will just exchange rocks with USA and they'll be able to get their deuce back. At least that's the goal.
Here's a look at the Sweeting Yagi game. This is the third end. We showed you the previous end. It was a 1-1 tie. And it looks like one blue counting there. And that's Michelle Yagi picking up a single in the third. So she leads Val Sweeting 2-1. Playing the fourth.
Just gone back and forth, eliminated this shot rock.
You're just hitting
South
and rolling.
Korea still
like normal?
Sits to blue. U.S. will try and remove this and hopefully roll over towards the blue stone to the 12-foot, back 12-foot.
Yep, nine, hit and roll. We're hitting and rolling over there.
Yes, that is a baby. Up here in our broadcast area in Tavern United. Where the aroma of the fine food, I think, is getting to Maureen. Last stone for the US, facing a couple. Oh, and she gets both.
That's an excellent shot because now Team USA has one biting the 12 foot. And it's going to force South Korea to draw for one, unless she thinks she can hit that out of there and not jam it. She's electing to peel it out of there and roll out to blank the end.
Fourth end. And there is a jam. And it wasn't what they had planned, but Team Korea is going to have to take one. So they score one here in the fourth. And we now have a 2-2 tie. Heading for the fifth end. Team USA and Team Korea. Real cat and mouse game. Let's go to sheet five. Christy McDonald and Darcy Robertson in a close one as well.
Well, these two teams have battled throughout the years against each other, so you know, they know each other, they know the style each other play. A number of the players on this team, on each team, have played, you know, against each other throughout the years as well on different teams. Christy has a new front end this year. She played third, Christy herself played third for Chelsea Carey last year and has chose to go back to skipping. And her front end was a front end of years ago with Leslie Wilson and Renora Westcott.
And that match is tied 1-1, McDonald and Robertson. Our game is tied 2-2. We'll be back with a little more of our match right now.
No.
9-3.
Well, you called it, Maureen. You felt like this might be a tight one, and really, it's just been an exchange of singles, missed shots.
Yeah, there's been missed opportunities, you know, for multiple end counting points on multiple end counting. So, you know, I think they're just going to play it fairly simple from here on in. You know, they've got an 8-end game. You're almost halfway through. Everybody seems, again, we're playing on this side of the sheet. It's interesting. We haven't played a lot on the intern side going away. They seem to be preferring this outturn. So we'll see what happens this end. We've got a guard up. South Korean has a guard up front.
A reminder, stick around after the fifth end. We'll speak to the skips. We'll get some thoughts as we head to the final three ends of our eight-end World Curling Tour match here. This is an elimination game. If you're just joining us, we're back on the air at 8:30 to see the two C event finals and see who qualifies for tomorrow's playoffs. Six rinks are already in, including Jennifer Jones. Lots of Manitoba flavor on the ice right now. Christy McDonald, Darcy Robertson tied at one. Barb Spencer leads Allie Flaxie 1-0, and it's Val Sweeting and Michelle Yagi in a battle. It's 2-1 Yagi curling the fourth. And in our game, a 2-2 tie between Nina Roth of the U.S. and Eun Jung Kim of Korea.
And Nina Roth is just asking for this guard to be healed and roll to the side, potentially take the back out as well and double those off. Keeping it clean this end, not getting into too much trouble. And she just missed the back one. Jung Kim will just split the house, it looks like. Interesting that she doesn't have the hammer, but she's going to split it in lie two. Looking for a force to force the U.S. to take one this end.
Wouldn't be something you normally see?
Well, you know, she's you could play aggressive and put the guard up front and you know, play a little cat and mouse with the U.S. team to see if they go around it or if they play down to the back one. But this is an okay call as well. You know, now the U.S. has to decide whether they want to keep hitting and hopefully stick and not roll out or play down to the back rock, draw down. Yeah, or hit and roll. So it there's no wrong call. It's just it's what the team prefers playing to your team's strengths as well. I like the call. It forces the U.S. team to make their shots.
Second stone for Becca Hamilton. USA with last rock here in the fifth. 2-2 tie.
That was an added bonus getting the double there. Yeah. again, South Korea will put one in the house.
Here's Team Korea third, Kong A Kim. And we've mentioned they've been extremely busy on the World Curling Tour early in the season. This is their fifth event. A record of, overall record of 14 wins, 10 losses.
Yeah, they've been to Sweden, Calgary, Vernon, Kamloops, and now Portage the Prairie in Manitoba, so they've been across the country. Should say Patty Withrich coaching them over the last 18 months. She's made several trips back and forth to South Korea to work with this team, as well as meeting them across Canada at these events. It's a lot of dedication, and Patty has been renowned for her curling abilities, and you know, this is a great asset to the Korean team to have her as their coach. I'm sure Hans and Patty just wave at each other in the airport when they, because Hans is all over the world making ice and instructing on how to make great ice, so.
Well, that's another thing. I mean, you just can't learn this game at an elite level if you're not curling on half-decent ice.
Yeah.
We've heard the horror stories about curling on hockey rinks. And
brings the natural ice back into it, throwing on ice that is heavy and ice that falls and is negative ice. When we say negative ice, you actually... you're throwing the opposite of what you think you should be throwing, and it's tiring and exhausting to, you know, play on ice that is not well made, I guess. And it's wonderful to have such experienced ice makers in Manitoba and across Canada, and I think Shorty Jenkins and Hans were the cowboys that started that whole ride and created this elite ice maker fraternity that we have out here today. So we're just exchanging rocks this end and keeping it clean.
Into skip stones. Here's the first from Eun Jung Kim.
So Mike, have you done any curling in your career?
Career?
Uh-huh.
I've curled recreationally at best, Maureen.
Well, you didn't go in the MCA bond spill, the big bond spill, and go through the 15 games or so that you have to play to get out of your event and win a spot to go in the Safeway Select?
Well, I don't know about that. I've often thought of doing one, though. Just for the enjoyment, but no spectators would be allowed.
Well, I saw Brian Pallister last week at the Bobcat Wall of Fame induction, and he said he was interested in getting back into it, so maybe there's a skip for you. You might see him here tonight. He might be here, so you could ask him then.
I think I would make a grade fifth, you know.
Oh, yes.
Team driver, perhaps. Take the food orders. Make sure the hotel keys are handed out.
Carry the brooms.
Now you had a career.
Well, I hope to still have one, but mm-hmm. we I've played a lot, had lots of support along the way, and played with a lot of wonderful people, met a lot of wonderful people across Canada. That's the beauty of curling. You meet so many people from different walks of life, and they're friends for life. I can go in pretty much any rink across Canada, and I'll likely know somebody that's curling in that rink, and that's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's incredible. And you've likely beat most of them, too.
I wouldn't say that. They've likely beat upon me several times over. But I know, like, the hospitality, we used to go out to Halifax, and Colleen Jones's team would invite us over for fresh lobster and, you know, just really great experiences off the ice as well as on the ice, and just makes it that much more memorable when you look back on some of the events that you get to go in. I'm sure these teams will have the same to remember in their day as well, so it's fun.
Last rock, fifth end, Team USA looking for the blank, and they get it. And so we're through five with interviews with both skips coming up. A 2-2 tie, sudden death game. The winner moves on to our 8:30 draw. The loser is eliminated. There's your score, 2-2. Team USA, Nina Roth. Team Korea, Eun Jung Kim. Stay tuned for much more from the Can-Am Inns Women's Classic coming your way next on Shaw TV.
Joined by Nina Roth, the skip for Team USA. Are you happy with how you guys have played so far?
Yeah, we've stuck with our game plans and are playing really well, so hopefully we can just finish it out.
Now it's tied 2-2, and how do you guys finish this strong?
Well, right now we have the hammer coming home, so we're hoping to get our deuce. So we'll just stick to that game plan.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Nina. All right, we'll bring in Eun Jung Kim from Team Korea right away. All right, Eun Jung Kim, tied 2-2, fifth end break. How do you guys finish this game strong?
일단 6엔드에서는 1점을 스틸하는 게 가장 큰 목표고, 그 다음 차선책으로는 1점을 주고, 그 다음에 후공을 가지고 가서 2점을 따는 걸로.
We goals is steal next end, must be steal, and if we didn't, maybe force give 1 point.
All right. Thank you so much, ladies. Stay tuned. We'll have more from the Can-Am Inns Women's Classic live from Portage La Prairie.
Can-Am Inns Destination Centers. Proud to support our community with 10 destination centers in Manitoba.
Levitt Machinery WHL Hockey is live on Shaw. Watch Wednesday, October 29th, when the Prince Albert Raiders roll into Alberta's Windy City for a dust-up with the Lethbridge Hurricanes. Levitt Machinery WHL Hockey, only on Shaw.
To us at Shaw TV, community isn't just an area of the city, it's the people who make up our Winnipeg. Shaw TV's Go Winnipeg covers your event better than anyone else, telling your story thoroughly and uniquely. We try to look past the simple facts for what really makes a connection for our viewers. And we prefer to focus on the happy stories that matter most at our community level. That's what I like most about working at Shaw TV.
Welcome back to Portage. Mike Beauregard, Maureen Bonner, Jessica Cable, and our Crack Shaw TV curling crew. Proud to be bringing you the Can-Add-Ins Women's Classic, the inaugural edition. And how's that for a nice shot? We have four elimination games going on right now in the C event. Winners advance to the finals tonight. Losing teams are eliminated, and we have a couple of sisters on the ice right now. Darcy Robertson is in a battle with Christy McDonald, tied at three after five ends of play. And Barb Spencer, another three-time provincial champion, leading Allie Flaxie 2-1. In our other sudden death match, it's Val Sweeting leading Michelle Yagi of Switzerland 4-2. Winners advance, and they'll play off tonight at 8:30 for the right to get into the playoffs tomorrow. Eight teams qualify for the playoffs. We'll have the final tomorrow night here on Shaw at 6 o'clock.
You mentioned about the two sisters out there playing on different sheets, Barb Spencer and Darcy Robertson. As well, Barb has her two daughters playing with her. Barb Spencer has Katie and Holly Spencer. So that's a new addition of the second daughter to her rink.
And isn't that something? You know, only in curling. I mean, do you think Barb would still be playing if it wasn't for the daughters being a part of her team?
Well, I think she had it planned, you know, that at some point she would play with her daughters. And it's wonderful to see that they're not only playing with her, but they're playing really well. And her one daughter, Katie, played in a national championship with her.
Barb, as I mentioned, a three-time Manitoba champion, former Canadian junior champion. Our match is tied 2-2. Into the sixth end now. They faced off earlier in this event with the USA winning 6-3. Much tighter game this time.
And just tap that rock back. It's now USA will just, Nina Roth will remove that South Korean stone in the 8 foot. Hoping to generate her to this end as she blanked the last end, the fifth end. Opportunity to lay two, so that'll give South Korea the chance to draw in around the front guard, the center line guard.
Here's Sung Young Kim, the second for Team Korea. Three wins, two losses in this event, heading into this match. As Barb mentioned, they've been all over Canada trying to get their game in shape for their significant events coming up overseas, European Championships among them.
Nina Roth has asked for this 4-foot rock of South Korea's 4-foot rock to be removed. Hopefully stick around, roll to this 12-foot and nicely executed.
Team USA has a 2-2 record. They have victories over Chelsea Carey and Team Korea. They have lost to Jill Thurston and Margarita Sigfridsson of Sweden. Thurston and Sigfridsson are into the playoffs tomorrow.
Yes, Thurston went through the A and Sigfridsson went through the B event to qualify. This was an interesting call here, Mike. She elected to go with the far outside takeout versus the one in the forefoot where she could have hit and rolled behind and sat on the button. So now USA Nina Roth will just remove this stone and hit and stick right there, or even just a little bit of a roll to the right just to spread those out so there's no double.
Becca Hamilton, Team USA second. She's going to lose the shooter.
It's a couple rocks down that spot that both teams have lost the rock. It's rolled away, so maybe just a little bit straighter out there, surprising them. This will give an opportunity now for South Korea to either hit and roll or draw in. She's going to go with the hit and roll.
Here's a look at sheet four. They're into skip stones in the match between Yagi and Val Sweeting. Sweeting has two yellow stones in the house. And a 4-2 lead, curling the fifth. Yagi has hammer. We'll keep you updated on that match.
On this side, 9-5.
And South Korea just removed that stone and rolled just on the open side to the right. And now Nina Roth is asking her third to come around, draw around. Sorry, second. No, that's third. And just doesn't want to be deep on this rock. You need it in front of the tee line. Yeah, that came a little bit too deep. This is a great opportunity for South Korea to put one in there. If they can get it just half buried around the top guard, biting the forefoot, covering the button, it will be a little bit of a difficult rock for USA. Earlier in the game, they were coming up short here on this outturn side, and now it's starting to slide pretty good. So I think they've broken it down now, and they're not adjusting a little bit to the change in that side of the ice. You know, that's a really important key that you know, a lot of rinks have to be aware of how many rocks have gone down that side of the ice, and you know, when we're coming up short a couple ends ago, how many more rocks have gone down there. It'll have keened up that much, breaking down the pebble a little bit. So you have to adjust and be aware of those things. This is a battle for the button right now. very nice weight. Although I think she can see about three quarters of this rock, so she has indicated she just wants to come down and tap it back. See a great shot of that rock and where she needs to come down and tap it back. Looks so much easier from up here, Mike. I think I'm more nervous watching than when I'm playing.
Down to skip stones now. In the sixth end, the U.S. has the hammer.
This just hung out on her. She rolled into the open, and now that gives an opportunity for the U.S. to come in again and possibly lay two.
There's nowhere to get rid of that energy when you're up here.
That's right. Just talk a lot, right?
That nervous energy.
I mean, this is shot anyway, so you don't need to hit it.
To get something buried.
I think so. That way? Or this is the side we want to bury?
I think this way, yeah.
Here.
Even if you show a piece, that's fine. Do you want it full four or a bit high? You want second shot?
If we can get underneath,
okay,
then full four. All right.
And what she means by underneath is completely buried behind that top guard.
All right. The idea is to just block this side. I do. But main priority. So full four is good. But yeah, we just gotta bury a piece at the end, so. 95?
She needs to block off that back rock so that forces South Korean to make a delicate shot. So she wants this in full 4 foot, covering the button, and hopefully fully buried. Not too much to ask, is it?
Just cleaning it at this point.
Nicely done. Really came in nice on the intern. Like they, you know, South Korea could look at, they didn't even touch, the U.S. didn't even hardly touch that as it came by here. They just lightly brushed it and it just bent in there behind that guard. So there is some opportunity to come down on that intern to maybe do a tap back. But now I think she's looking at just maybe forcing a one coming down and sitting on top of that yellow one. A delicate shot again. If she's looking at tapping that back, she could potentially line up a three for the U.S. team. So this is a really important shot here. I think the best option would be to draw down and sit on top of that yellow one and force her to draw, the U.S. to draw for two.
Oh, 더블하고 나면 이게 이렇게 나오니까 이게 이렇게 나오네. 그럼 어차피 2점이잖아. 살짝 진짜 살짝 맞고 이렇게만 깎으면 나쁘진 않긴 한데 여기만 서도. 근데 문제는 이렇게 맞으면 어차피 이게 여기를 부딪힐 거면
If she did come down on the intern and sit on top of that yellow rock biting the button, it would be a difficult shot to remove.
범퍼에서 아니면 이렇게 하고 내려놓으면
And it would make it difficult for the US team to get their deuce.
그러니까 이거를 움직이려면 프리즈는 그냥 이거를 무조건 이기게 놔두는 거잖아.
Certainly the lengthiest discussion we've had in this game.
For sure.
Obviously a critical point in this game, a 2-2 tie.
내말 아예 이걸 쳐서 약간 팀에서 해놓으면 이게 뒤로 가면 일단 1번이 우리께 되잖아. 그래서. 근데 좀 위험하긴 위험하다. 아니면. 아, 그냥 프리즈.
She corners that. There's an opportunity. It has to be perfect. Otherwise, she may set up a potential three.
맞으면,
Doesn't seem real sure of this call. She's talking it over with the front end as well, and of the consequences of her shot if she makes this or if she doesn't. So.
말고에서 범퍼 해서 밀어놓고 위로 올리면 아니면 히트 롤에서 프리즈나 그거나 둘 다 효과는 똑같잖아.
Really talking herself through this, making sure she has the right weight.
그러니까 그게 만약에 얇게 맞고 이렇게 가서 이쪽으로 흘러 내려오면은 보일 수도 있어. 근데 생각보다 공간이 많이 그거 되는 것 같긴 한데. 아니면 경희 범퍼로 히트 롤 보고 갈래? 프리즈 비슷하게 어차피
이거요? 아니요? 이거는 너무 쉽게 질 것 같아요.
아?
이거 하면 너무 쉽게 질 것 같아요. 여기 붙이면 야들이 할 게 없어요.
So some indecision, Maureen.
Yeah, they seem to be caught between coming off of their own blue one into the button or coming down and sitting on top of the yellow one, straight draw. The two options there, but I think they just need to clarify which one they're playing because that's the dilemma when you're going in the hack and throwing a rock and you have two shots in your head.
Well, evidently they have. USA has the hammer here in the sixth and they have one on the lid right now. Last stone from Eun Jung Kim. 2-2 tie.
I think she's trying to come through that hole, just nick off her own.
They do not have shot.
I think they'll be pretty happy with that. USA will have to get their deuce, will have to remove one of that blue rock that Chung Kim just placed there. It was interesting. I don't know if the third was really sold on what the shot was. So she was yelling no, and Chung Kim was yelling yes, and so it ended up very well.
The only other way I get two, I think, right? Is there, what's the risk here? You're wide and do this?
Yep.
Give up a steal of one?
Yep.
Is that worth it? In the sixth end?
It's a great discussion Jamie's having with Nina right now. Touching that blue, you risk possibly taking your own yellow out of there.
Okay.
It's risky.
If you think it's worth it, then
I think I can play back line. Okay. Final.
All right.
Come take a look.
You can only see half from the other end, eh?
But you gotta move it out of the forefoot. So you gotta get to nose.
They only have a third.
Well, but we're just playing back line. Yeah. I mean, worst situation, I do this. And they get one.
Definitely weighing all the options here, what they could possibly give up if they don't make the shot. They think they will only give up one.
Okay. Yep.
But the reward would be that they could pump that blue one right back and possibly get three, maybe two for sure. I'm not sure if they knows that, if they could actually get three, so it would be for two.
Last rock, sixth end. Team USA already lying one. But a delicate shot needed for multiple points here. It doesn't get by the guard. And so they're forced to take one here in the sixth. And lead 3-2, but give up the hammer headed for the seventh. So 3-2 is our score. Team USA leads Team Korea. Back with much more of the Canadiens Women's Classic right after this.
Destination Centers, proud to support our community with 10 destination centers in Manitoba.
Don't miss the latest blockbuster on Shaw On Demand, The Purge Anarchy. Take a look.
As long as we keep moving, we're okay.
People like us, we don't survive tonight.
They're taking us.
This is the last purge of the evening.
At Shaw TV, we are proud to bring you live events and we value your comments. Call the Shaw TV viewer response line now, 204-480-3500, or email us, shawtvwinnipeg@shaw.ca, and let us know how we're doing. Or find us on Facebook and Twitter at Shaw TV Winnipeg.
Welcome back to Portage. The Portage Curling Club. We're up in Tavern United here at the Can-Ed Inns facility. Mike Beauregard, Maureen Bonner, Jessica Cable. Our featured match, an elimination game in the C event, has Team USA leading Team Korea 3-2. Just started the seventh end. Updating our other games, Christy McDonald has taken a 5-3 lead on Darcy Robertson, a steal of two for McDonald in the sixth end. It's Val Sweeting leading Michelle Yagi 4-3. And Barb Spencer with a slim 2-1 lead on Allie Flaxey of Ontario. Winners of these elimination games will play at 8:30 tonight. And the winners of those games will advance to tomorrow's playoffs. We'll be back on the air tomorrow night, 6 o'clock, with our championship game. And back on the air tonight at 8:30. to see who advances to the playoffs. But first things first, we'll have to get through this draw and our featured game, which has been really a tight affair. Only singles exchanged, in fact.
Well, the score isn't indicative of that last end. That was quite an end. And Eun-Jung Kim, I can never say her name, knew I wouldn't get it right, but she made a heck of a shot in that last end to force, and that's what she talked about at the break, that she wanted to force them to one, and she succeeded. So kept this game very tight, and exchanges of 1 point, force, lots of forces going on in this game.
These teams met earlier in the round robin with the USA winning 6-3.
That's an excellent shot from South Korea. Now we're playing a little cat and mouse again, Mike. They're going to, U.S. team is going to ask for a draw in to the outturn to sit on the corner of that South Korean rock.
Yeah, but then at least we have a play on that side.
Not if we corner freeze. Okay.
Well, they discussed it, and they're going to go with the intern draw. And corner freeze on the other side. So follow South Korean rock down.
Team USA curling out of the National Training Center in Blaine, Minnesota. But a collection of players from all over the U.S.
Well, it wasn't a corner freeze, but it did come back to the back one, and so we're creating a little pocket here for this team, South Korean team, to put another one in there. South Korean team is taking a lot of time in their discussions between the third and the skip, and we're in early into the end. So, you know, if there was time limits on this, this would really impact on their time. As they've gone to talk time in a lot of the national championships and international play, this would definitely be a lot of time used up. They'd have to be watching their time clock.
Freeze.
If they had the luxury to watch the Kevin Martin team or any of the men's teams, they would be down on the corner freezing to that top rock immediately. There would be no discussion.
Well, I guess that's part of their evolution, huh, as young curlers and playing against better competition over here and I guess facing more difficult scenarios at times as well, you know, the
for
better
sure.
the competition. But still debating it. We're still in second stones.
Might be discussing the ice as well and the weight. She's gonna get herself reset up in the hack to throw this rock now that she's got all the information she needs to make the shot. There's so much more involved in the game, you know, today, especially in women's curling. You know, they talk about time of rocks and you know, ice paths, and there's so much to take in, and everybody has a role on the team to be aware of what's going on out on the ice and what role they play and what they're supposed to be relaying to the third so that that third can relay it onto the skip. So lots of discussion in the hack, and then once you're ready to throw, no more discussion, get to the business at hand.
Long as she's light, so.
Can I have a bit more, please?
Into third stones now, the third for Team USA, Jamie Sinclair.
Yep.
3-2 for Team USA. In the seventh end.
Came up a little short there, wanting to corner freeze to the South Korean rock. Now this is giving the opportunity for South Korea to draw in around that guard just placed there and possibly get their deuce. That's what they're looking for at this point. With all these rocks in play, they're going to have to look to set up for a deuce. It's always that dilemma, though, Mike. Do you want to get your deuce on the seventh end and go into the eighth end, one up without the hammer? Or do you prefer to just keep it clean on the seventh end and go for your deuce on the eighth end?
Well, looks like that opportunity has passed them by, huh?
Long gone.
Here's Kong A Kim, the third for Team Korea. They have the hammer here in the seventh. Trying to draw undercover.
You know, she didn't get it into to count, but it's a great shot because it closes off that draw, outturn draw. The U.S. will not be able to draw that around that turn. So they're going to have to make a plan that because it's actually a dangerous rock being in there. South Korea can bump it up. So now the panic is that USA will want to get another rock in there.
But then you might open it up. I got this one. My shooter's... Yeah. My shooter should guard their one that they just threw, and then.
Sweeping this rock in, it's coming around that guard. She had great line on that rock.
I'm just gonna run. I'm just throwing D line. But you're throwing 7-8 weight. Yeah.
Thank you. What's Jamie going to do here, Maureen?
Well, it looks like she's playing the tap up on that front guard. The only thing here is if you don't make the perfect tap up and you open it up, you're basically giving South Korea an opportunity to get another one in there. But if she makes it perfect, like it looks like she will, well, not bad. Except now she staggered her front guard, so that's basically cut off that raise for future. And opened it up on the outturn side so that Korea can put a, South Korea can put another rock in there. She's looking at hitting this rock. I'm not sure why, or maybe she's just getting her line up. Yeah, she's electing to hit this rock and roll in. The easier shot would have been to just draw on this. But she might see that there might be a hit and roll to the back yellow line or hit and roll behind. That really didn't work out that well. Now she's left the US team an open draw, or not an open draw, but an outturn draw around cover. You heard Nina say short is better than deep. You don't want to go deep on this rock, even if she uses this as a setup shot for her next and her last shot. She wants to be just half tucked around that the front guards. And if it looks like it's going to go in, they'll sweep it in to around those guards and bury it.
The first of Skip Stones here in the seventh. Team Korea has the hammer.
And it looks like the U.S. might be shot. Hard to tell from up here, but it looks close. And Jun Kim is just asking her teammates to sit in the hack down at the other end to see how much they can see of that yellow stone. She's also lining it up to see if there's a double, angled double. If she were to make this double mic, she'd be lane two if she successfully took the double out.
3분의 1. 3분의 1부터 안 보이는 것 같은데, 아까보다.
에이, 진짜 조금 보이네. 완전 조금 보이는데.
너무 조금 보여, 완전.
컨트롤.
컨트롤. 그리고 앞에 거.
The thing with this double mic is that she's going to be hitting and rolling away from the center of the ice, so she'll still leave the same shot for Nina Roth, the U.S. team, to draw in again.
Well, certainly not an easy shot. First stone of the seventh end for Eun Jung Kim. And she doesn't get by the guard. So the USA with shot stone.
Well, this leaves a huge opportunity for the US to put the pressure back on South Korean and come in there. She can come in and basically draw down to that one she just put there or put the guard up, and a couple options there. She'd want to bring it in close enough to take away the side run, that side rock in, South Korean rock in. So she should come in through past the guards just to maybe even bite the 12 foot or come right in on top of her, the one she put there earlier.
All right, 2-3, just a guard.
Yeah, I think she's elected, just
think we'll want to
guard it.
Just a guard.
Last stone for Nina Roth. Trying to manufacture a steal here in the seventh, trying to protect shot stone. With a high guard.
I think she may be looking at that side rock to run it in. Well, if you have to run a rock in, it's nice that it's your own rock that you're running in. So she'll try and angle this in onto the yellow and possibly make the double again that she had called with her first rock.
Stay tuned following this match. We'll have interviews with the skips. And we're back on the air tonight at 8:30 to determine the final two finalists for the playoffs. Last rock, seventh in, critical shot. And Team Korea will pick up one, tie the game at three, but give up the hammer heading home. So the score, Team USA 3, Team Korea 3. Clearly one there for Team Korea. We're back with the eighth end of play. In just a moment, you're watching the Canadiens Women's Classic on Shaw TV.
CANAD INS Destination Centers. Proud to support our community with 10 destination centers in Manitoba.
At Shaw TV, we are proud to bring you live events and we value your comments. Call the Shaw TV viewer response line now, 204-480-3500, or email us, shawtvwinnipeg@shaw.ca, and let us know how we're doing. Or find us on Facebook and Twitter at Shaw TV Winnipeg.
We have a measurement going on. Three-three is what we think the score is. Heading for the eighth and final ends, an elimination game between Team Korea and Team USA. There won't be much turnaround time for the winners of these elimination games on the ice right now because they're back at it at 8:30, and so will we here at Shaw TV. And it was indeed the USA scoring one. Team Korea scoring one. So the USA with the hammer for the pivotal eighth end in a 3-3 tie. Just updating our other games out there, it's Christy McDonald leading Darcy Robertson 5-4 now, curling the eighth end, and a couple of tie games going on. Michelle Yagi and Val Sweeting are tied at 4, and Barb Spencer and Allie Flaxie tied at 2. As we get down to the nitty-gritty in these games, the winners move on to play tonight. The losing teams are eliminated.
And you can catch highlights and behind-the-scenes footage of tonight's match on our Facebook and Twitter pages. Just search for Shaw TV Winnipeg. We'll also be streaming.
So South Korea is going to has put up the center guard, and USA is trying to do a pick. Of course, they can't remove that rock out of play, and if so, they'd have to return the rock to its original position, but they've done an excellent job with that pick. They'll be happy with it, even though the rocks are in play, and South Korea will put up another center guard.
Jessica Cable has joined us in the booth. Are you here to just pick up some food or actually do some work?
Oh, I wish I was here to pick up some food. No, I'm here to tell you that we are streaming tonight's game and the game again at 8:30 on our YouTube channel, and you can find that link on our Facebook and Twitter pages by searching Shaw TV Winnipeg. And we're also going to be giving you highlights from tonight's games as well as just a little behind-the-scenes looks at what goes into the broadcast. And again, just search for Shaw TV Winnipeg.
And if you have any questions?
Yeah, just tweet us or Facebook us your questions, and we will ask the skips. The next game, we'll be talking to them at the beginning of the game, fifth end break, and at the end of the game. So if you have any questions, send them our way on Twitter and Facebook.
Or perhaps any curling inquiries to Maureen Bonner, or
yes.
The odd maybe a stumper.
For sure. It wouldn't take much. But.
Stump the expert.
Again, the U.S. team is asked to do the pick. The lead picked the first one, and she did it again on the second one. Great job by her. Nina Ross lead, Tabitha Peterson. And as a skip, she's sighing relief now, Nina is. You always want to keep that forefoot open when you have the hammer and you're tied up.
And a reminder, Jessica Cable will have interviews with our skips following this game. It's been a tight one throughout, and it's tied at three as we play the eighth and final end. C-Event semifinals here at the Canadiens Women's Classic. Good crowd on hand here tonight. And we're back on the air tomorrow night at 6 o'clock with the championship final. Three draws here tomorrow if you're interested in coming down. 10 a.m. the quarterfinals. Semifinals are at 2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. And then the final over dinner time. Jennifer Jones, if you're counting the event last year at the Fort Rouge, the old Liquor and Lotteries Classic, Jennifer Jones is the defending champion. Unofficially, this is the inaugural Canadiens Women's Classic here in Portage, but a continuation of the event that we've had in Winnipeg for close to a decade. And back-to-back huge women's events with a Grand Slam event coming up in Selkirk next weekend.
We have a little mix-up on sheet five of rocks from the next sheet over, so they've taken a little bit of time out to replace the proper rocks to the right sheets.
And that means a lot at the elite level.
For sure. You get used to throwing a pair of rocks, certain rocks, throughout the game, and they feel good. You know the weight, so you want to make sure you keep those rocks throughout the game, especially if you like them. Nina Roth is continuing to ask her team to clear off the front, and they have been doing that successfully.
Now, if you were to have rocks from another sheet get mixed in, how would you tell them apart? Because they have the same numbers, do they not?
Yeah, they're usually there's usually either a sheet number on the rock with the number of the rock, or where it's ABC sometimes. But I think what happened was there's an open area at the back of the sheet where the rocks sit when they're not being thrown, and the two blue colors on each sheet got set beside each other, which normally you try and put the yellow where the opposite sheet has the blue, and they got mixed up, and they had to stop the game and take about three down and replace them with the other three. The other team was looking for the rocks frantically, going, where did they go? But I think it's all clear now, and got them at the right place. Again, South Korea will put a guard up front. At this point, you're trying to look for a place to put that guard where potentially the U.S. might jam it on something, you know, might get fortunate enough to come off of one that's in play on the side. So Nina Roth is looking at the angles here to make sure that she can successfully remove that stone without jamming on any other rocks.
Last of the third stones, here's Jamie Sinclair. Just looking to peel that guard.
Gee, I feel like I jinxed her on that, saying something about jamming onto other rocks. But anyway, so this worked out better for South Korea. They can put a guard up again, and they have one biting the forefoot. A ray of hope towards setting up for a steal. I'll have to apologize to Jamie for that gangster. So often you see that happen, though, Mike. You know, you're going along, you're keeping the end clean, and, you know, just by, you know, bad angle or unfortunate circumstance, that jams, and you just go, wow. Play the whole end to keep it clean, and that happens. A number of my friends don't curl, and so they don't understand the game that well, and they always think it would have been neat to just play off the boards.
Into skip stones now in the eighth end. The first from Oon Jung Kim. Trying to keep her playoff hopes alive.
Great guard. And Nina Roth will go down and peel that off.
First stone for Nina Roth. She has the hammer here in the eighth. Team Korea lying shot.
So the discussion here will be, do I put the same guard in front or do I bring it in tighter and play a little bit of into USA's head and have him make a double or draw, right? So I think she'll just put the guard on it. She has, will give Nina, I guess, a full draw to the forefoot or button. I think if she wanted to put down the perfect draw, though, it'd be just sort of showing a little bit of that rock on the outside and covering closer to the middle of the sheet. Tightens up a little bit of the ice for Nina and when she has to throw to the forefoot.
Now, as a skip, Maureen, how would you stay calm out there knowing you've got a big shot coming up? Because Nina Roth is standing back there with her third, Jamie Sinclair, knowing that she's probably going to have to come up with a draw, last rock draw to win this game.
Well, as soon as that jam happened, you have to get it in your head right then and there that I'm going to the forefoot for the win. And you just have to believe that that's what you're going to do and set your mind in that track, that thinking.
Much tighter draw this time, and so the stage is set.
And this is that outturn draw that has been kind of questionable throughout the game. So, you know, a good play by South Korea to force the outturn draw. This will be all up to the sweepers. Get it to the full forefoot for the win. Keep it clean.
Heavy sigh coming from Nina Roth. Last rock, eighth end. 3-3 tie. Needs full forefoot for the victory.
Well done.
And she draws to the button. So the USA with a last rock draw in the eighth defeats Team Korea by a score of 4-3. They move on to our 8:30 draw for a chance to advance to tomorrow's playoffs. We're back with our post-game show in a moment. We'll talk to the winning skip. Team USA defeats Team Korea 4-3. Here at the Canadiens Women's Classic. Back with much more in just a moment.
Tavern United, a new world sports pub with pub cuisine for lunch and dinner. And a wide selection of sporting events televised at our 7 locations in Manitoba. Tavern United.
Hi, my name's Tamika, and I host Switch on Shaw TV. Switch is a platform for community members to share different philosophies, cultures, and activities that happen in Winnipeg. And I think that's super cool.
Now I'm going to plant the vegetables that I've started from seeds.
Switching up television.
I think it just means someone who loves the pop culture.
Run by volunteers.
Who I am online is who I am offline.
Community created on Shaw TV.
Hi, I'm Joe Poplosky. Ranger Insurance provides insurance coverage for Manitobans. We believe in building relationships and are proud supporters in the community. For more information, please visit rangerinsurance.ca.
Nina Roth joins me for the third and final time tonight. Congrats on the win. Are you happy with how your team played tonight?
Yes, very happy. They played great.
And how do you carry this momentum of this win forward to your next game? You guys play again at 8:30.
We're just going to stay focused, try to keep on a little roll that we're on, and make some more shots.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Nina. And thank you to our Shaw broadcast crew, Maureen and Mike. And we are on Facebook and Twitter. Make sure you check those pages out for highlights from today's game. We will be back from Portage la Prairie at 8:30 live to see who makes the finals at the Canadiens Women's Classic live from Portage la Prairie, Manitoba.
At Shaw TV, we are proud to bring you live events and we value your comments. Call the Shaw TV viewer response line now, 204-480-3500, or email us, shawtvwinnipeg@shaw.ca, and let us know how we're doing. Or find us on Facebook and Twitter at Shaw TV Winnipeg.